Hi there. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to construct a process chart, or pChart, to track the number of unsatisfied patients at a hospital. This question relates to problem S6.19 in your text. Here's our data. The Toronto General Hospital wants to improve the patient experience by improving food services with tasty, inviting patient meals that are also healthful. A questionnaire accompanies each meal, asking the patient whether or not they're satisfied or unsatisfied with the meal. So a 100-patient sample of the survey results over the past 7 days yielded the following data in the table. So as you can see, we have 100 patients sampled per day. That's a total of 700 patients. Our objective is to construct a pChart that plots the percentage of patients unsatisfied with their meals, and we'll set the control limits to include 99.73% of the random variation in meal satisfaction, and then comment on the results. When we mean 99.73%, this refers to the area underneath the standard normal curve. And if you're handing or remembering some of your Z values, that corresponds to Z equals 3, or 3 sigma level of quality, 3 standard deviations. Okay, so let's get on with doing what we need to do. First, what we want to do is determine what the upper and lower control limits need to be. Recall from our previous work that the formula for the upper and lower control limits for the pcharts are equal to p bar plus or minus the number of standard deviations, or z, times the standard deviation of the sampling distribution. The first thing we need is p bar, or the overall average portion of defects. Well, we can calculate p bar to be equal to the sum of all of the number of unsatisfied patients, which happens to be 122. So p bar is equal to total unsatisfied patients in the survey divided by the total number surveyed. So that is 122 over a total of 700. And remember that 700 is 7 days times a sample size of 100. And that will give us an average proportion of unsatisfied patients of 0.1743, or roughly 17.43%. The next part of the equation we need is the standard deviation of the sampling distribution. So sigma p hat is equal to, remember, the square root of p bar times 1 minus p bar over n. So we have 0.1743. 1 minus that is 0.8257. The sample size is 100, and we take the square root of that, and that will give us a value of about 0.0379. Now we can determine that the upper control limit is equal to 0.1743 plus 3 standard deviations times 0.0379, and that is an upper control limit of 0.2881. The lower control limit, oh, I got ahead of myself here. There does need to be a little hat on top of these guys. It's just the upper control limits for the proportion. This is equal to 0.1743 minus 3 times 0.0379, and that gives us a lower control limit of 0.0605. So if we think in terms of percentages, this is about 28.8% unsatisfied at the upper limit and about 6.05% at the lower limit. The next step will be to create the control chart, but we might as well determine what the proportion of unsatisfied patients are each day, and we can just call that P. Since the sample size is a nice round 100%, 24 divided by 100 is a proportion of unsatisfied patients of 0.24, 24%. Then we'll have 0.22, 0.08, 0.15, 0.10, 0.26, and 0.17. So now let's go ahead and draw our chart. We're going to have a dotted center line at 0.1743. We're going to have an upper control limit at about 0.2881 and a lower control limit of 0.0605. Now we'll plot. We have 7 days. Day one is 24% or 0.24. So let's say that's somewhere about here. Second day, 0.22 there. 0.08, it's going to be, say, somewhere around there. 0.15 on the fourth day. 0.10 on the fifth day. Day six, 26, that's going to be like way up here. And on the seventh day, 17%, so just below the center line. If we want to connect our dots, we can see what the entire graph looks like. Can we comment on our results? Now we can, because all of our observations around the proportion of unsatisfied patients fall within the upper and lower control limits, we can say that the process is in control. And the variation within the upper and control limits is fairly random. There doesn't seem to be much of a trend. And that's it. That's how you do a pChart.